This interview is a joint production of WKTV Voices, the Grand Valley State University Veterans History Project, and the Silversides Museum in Muskegon, Michigan. We are, in fact, at the Silversides Museum in Muskegon, and we're talking first with Carol Sutton of Muskegon. So, Carol, begin with some background on yourself, and to begin with, where and when were you born?
I was born in Davis, West Virginia, in February 23rd, 1940.
Okay. And did you grow up there? Did you move around?
Yeah, I grew up there until I was 18. And then I went to the university and then transferred there to Francis Payne Bolton School of Nursing in Cleveland, Ohio.
Okay. So let's back up a little bit. What was your family doing for a living when you were growing up?
Well, my dad originally worked in the mines, and then he became an engineer on the railroad, and we had a garage, and my brother-in-law ran that when my father was away.
Okay. And so was that help you be able to stay in high school and then go on to college?
Mm-hmm.
Because they could afford to do that?
Right.
All right. And then what did you study in college?
Well, I started out with basic courses toward a medical degree, and then I decided maybe I don't want to do that. Maybe I'll just be a nurse.
Okay. So you were thinking about being a doctor.
Right.
First. Okay.
And then I decided maybe math and chemistry were not my forte.
All right. So did you then basically do pre-nursing? Or?
Yes.
Okay. But you did not get it. You weren't yet a nurse at the point when you finished there? Okay.
No.
And so when did you leave college?
I graduated in 1963.
Okay.
And then I took a trip with some friends to Europe, and then we drove down and flew to North Africa and traveled around through the Middle East.
Okay.
And after that, I joined the Air Force.
All right. So, I mean, how did you wind up making that extended tour?
Well, a friend of mine had a father that was in the Air Force in Tripoli, North Africa, and so we decided we wanted to go on a trip, so we started saving our money. And every time I wanted to spend more money, my friend would say, remember, we're going on a trip. So it was a fantastic trip. We took a freighter to Europe.
Okay.
And all young people were on it, and a young captain.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a great experience.
All right. Now, was it a group of women traveling together, or did you
have
some men?
No, it was, there were, I think, a couple people were men, and one was going back home to Holland and another to Germany.
Mm-hmm.
But I think there were more women.
Okay. But there was a whole group of you.
Yes. Well, the freighter only holds 12.
Mm-hmm.
So we had 11. Someone canceled at the last minute.
Okay. How long did the trip on the freighter take?
Oh, gee, it's been so long ago. It was probably 9 days or something.
Okay. Did you have decent weather, or?
Oh, they said it was the nicest crossing they'd had. And I thought, well, I wonder about that. Because you're still like this when you see the sky on one side and then the other. Excuse me.
All right. And so what countries did you visit?
No, we went all through Europe. Like, we landed in Belgium, and then we went to Germany and France and Belgium, Italy. And then we turned the car in and then flew to North Africa, where my friend's parents were.
Okay.
And stayed there a while, right on the Mediterranean, enjoying the water.
Mm-hmm.
And then we went to Egypt and Lebanon, Greece. It's so hard to remember when all of a sudden I start to think about it.
Well, yeah. No, and I guess at that point the dollar was pretty strong.
Oh, it was very strong.
So you could afford to do that kind
yes,
of thing. Go a decade later, it would have been a little bit trickier.
Yeah. Of course, salaries were less, too.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. All right. So you kind of had your world tour adventure, and then you came back. And then nursing school was the next stop?
No. I'd already finished school.
Okay.
And then I went to the Air Force.
Okay.
But we went to basic training in Montgomery, Alabama, which was a farce at that time for officers. They wanted us to at least be able to go through the parade, and the captain would say, come on, ladies, we have to do this. I mean, it was so lax and fun.
Okay. Just to clarify, did you get the nursing training at West Virginia, or was that at?
Well, I did 2 years pre at West Virginia and then 3 in Cleveland,
right,
Ohio.
Right, right. Okay. Just
yeah.
Kind of get that. Okay, right. And then, so you do that, then you take your trip, and then
right.
you go, okay. How did you wind up joining the Air Force?
Well, I planned to join the Navy, and two of my friends decided, one to get married, another to go to Texas. So I thought, okay. I just called up the Air Force recruiter. He came right over, and that's how it started.
Okay. And so then when do you actually arrive in Montgomery for your...
It was May of 65.
Of 65.
Yeah.
Okay. And is this Maxwell Air Force Base?
Or? Yes.
Okay. All right. And the group that you're training with, were they all women?
That was their class that had the most women of any of them. Lucky for us. There were two men.
Okay.
And they had, like, psychologists, and most of them were nurses. I can't remember what the other one did, but...
Okay. And then just to clarify, you're going in basically as an officer.
Right. Second lieutenant to
mm-hmm.
start with.
Yeah, because nurses are,
yeah.
are officers.
Yeah.
Do they explain to you why you got to come in as an officer?
No, I just seem to know that, you know, from being around a lot of people in the military.
Okay. Now, the basic training that you got, what did that actually consist of?
Well, we did a camp out and went out in the swamps and found, what would you call it? Like you'd find a little wooden things that would tell you where to go next, or
mm-hmm.
I'm not trying to think what, not ingredients, what do you call it? Coordinates or something.
Mm-hmm.
And that was, and we didn't do too much, met in the mornings and went over things all together, and the camp out was fun though.
I mean, did they try to train you to march or anything like that?
Just that part, so that we could at least be in the parade at the end of the
okay.
experience.
All right. Now, sometimes for the men, at least for the enlisted men, there's
mm-hmm.
a lot of attention to kind of the spit and
right.
polish and how to wear
right.
the uniform and how to clean things. Did you get some of that?
None of that.
Okay. They had just given up or weren't trying?
I think at that time, you know, you're going to be a nurse and... They didn't really think about your going out, like, to Vietnam, like some of them went.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And, of course, in 65, it wasn't yet clear how much of that there was going to be, because
mm-hmm.
it was only beginning to escalate at
mm-hmm.
that point. All right. Now, when you went there, while you were training there, did you consider the possibility that you might go overseas, or did you want to go overseas?
Well, I didn't really think about it at that time.
Okay. All right. So once you finish the basic training, where do they send you?
To Wilford Hall, Lackland Air Force Base.
Okay. And Lackland is a big base
right,
in
where
San
they
Antonio.
Train.
Okay. And then what kind of reception do you get when you arrive there?
Well, I was pretty nervous. But everybody was, you know, we already knew where we were going to be in Wilford Hall. But it was just like anything else. It's a little nerve-wracking to start with until you adjust and kind of get your feet on the ground there.
Did they do anything to orient you or help you get acquainted with the place, or do they just give you an assignment?
They all, as far as I remember, they orient you to where different areas are because it's a big area.
Okay. Now, describe the facility itself. What was Wilford like? How big was it? What was there?
Gee, it was pretty big. I can't remember now what all was there, but I know I got assigned to OB and gynecology.
Mm-hmm.
So I spent most of my time there.
Okay. And presumably a lot of the patients were the wives of
right,
men based there?
Right, right.
Okay. And what kind of living accommodations did you have?
Oh, I lived in an apartment with two other girls.
Okay, so you got to be off the base?
Right.
Okay. And did you have a car? Or?
Yes.
Okay. And what was the daily routine like?
Well, as far as my work?
Yeah.
Well, I started out being on days just for a while to get oriented. Like,
mm-hmm.
As being a nurse, I never drew blood before, so they sent me right to the lab to draw blood.
Mm-hmm.
And my first patient was a doctor, and I missed
oh.
on the first time. But after that, then, I didn't go there anymore because we would draw the patient's blood, just like their hematoglobin, hematocrit,
mm-hmm.
would be drawn and sent down to the lab.
Mm-hmm.
But,
Okay. And so then normally once you're in there, what are you doing day to day?
Well, just taking care of the patients, you know.
So essentially the same kinds of things that
you
see
do in a regular
doing.
Hospital, yes.
Okay. Now, were there things about that job that made it different from being in a civilian hospital?
I think pretty much the same at that time, because now they do so much more than we did back then.
Okay. And you said you worked days to begin with?
And yeah, then I was on evenings and nights, depending on what your schedule was.
Okay. And how long would the shifts be?
Back then it was only 8 hours.
Okay. All right. And then was it 5 days a week or six or?
Oh, we had every third weekend off.
Okay.
So it varied during the week.
All right. And what was, I don't, what was the atmosphere like there just in terms of being a young woman living in a place like this? I mean, how did people treat you or?
I don't think they treated me any different than most people do.
Mm-hmm.
I get along pretty well with most people anyway. But I remember back then, we had one nurse that was talking about, she was so sad she couldn't go march with Martin Luther King back then.
Okay. Now, was this facility, was this integrated? Did you have black nurses there? Or?
Oh, yeah, she was a black nurse.
Okay. All right. And were there a fair number of black personnel on the base? And
oh, yes.
Okay. And now this is still Texas in 1965,
66. Yes.
When you go off the base, were you aware at all of racial tensions or things like
no.
that?
No.
Okay, so it just wasn't. And by then, I guess you don't have segregated drinking fountains or.
Oh, no.
Anything like that.
But one of the girls from the South certainly let us know how our Northerners did not know about being in the South.
Mm-hmm. Well, what kind, were there customs or things that you weren't aware of, I mean, aside from the race issue that?
Just, no.
Okay. All right. Now, when you went into to the Air Force, how long did you expect to stay?
I was expecting to be a career woman.
Okay.
All and right. then I met my husband.
Okay.
He was working in, well, on the labor and delivery unit, and someone told him there was a tall nurse over there, so he came over to see who it was and talked to me off and on, and then I thought, well, I kind of like him, so I invited him over.
Mm-hmm. What were the rules for fraternization?
Well, they were a little more strict then, and Michael had to get when we were going to get married, he had to get some type of release that said, like, First Lieutenant Carol Ann Sutton, you know, and his name and everything. And they told him, you can't go to the officer's club. And he said, oh, gee, maybe I won't get married then. They got he got in a little trouble for that. But
okay, but it was still allowable. It wasn't totally forbidden.
Yeah, right.
Okay. Yeah. Now,
but they didn't encourage it, of course.
Yeah. Well, the stereotype that you get, at least from you know, like TV show MASH or things like this, is it's the nurses and the doctors are carrying on and so forth. And you wind up with an enlisted man.
Yeah.
Now, was that actually more common for if the nurses were going to get involved, they might be getting involved with the enlisted rather than
no,
the doctors? Or
I think whatever.
Okay. Because I have had a nurse explain to me at some point that the enlisted men were more your own age and had more in common with you, and the doctors were older and too many of them were married.
Yeah.
And so they shouldn't be doing anything.
Right.
Okay. But this just kind of happened.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yeah.
And then how does, so when do you get married?
We got married in July of 66.
Okay.
And then 11 months later, he went to Vietnam.
Okay. And then what did you do while he was in Vietnam?
Work.
Okay. So you just stayed on.
Right.
All right.
Yeah.
Now, were you working longer than your contractual obligation? Because when you signed up...
Yeah. Yeah, you... I believe it was 2 years.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So you signed up and you had to be full-time active duty for 2 years.
Right,
and then
least,
in the reserves after that.
Right.
Okay. But you wind up extending and staying for a third because at that point you might as well.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and then while he was in, well, I guess, how did you feel about him going to Vietnam?
I wasn't too happy about it because, of course, you're newly married and all in love and excited, and you mm-hmm. worry that they're not coming back.
Mm-hmm.
So.
All right. And then how much communication did you have with him while he was overseas?
Well, letters, and then we used to send tapes. And one time he was teasing me about, I'm talking about the rain and how romantic, and here he's sitting in a monsoon.
All right. And so that basically goes on for sort of your last
yeah.
year. And then when he comes back from the service, now what happens?
Yeah. Well, we met in Hawaii after 8 months,
mm-hmm.
or close to 9, I think. And then he came back in 68.
Okay. So he had an R&R to go to Hawaii.
Right, yeah.
yeah. All right. And I don't know, when he came out for the R&R, was he any different than he was when he left?
No. No, at least I didn't see it.
Okay. All right. And then when he does come back, then do you leave the Navy or go in reserves or what
yes.
happens?
Yes.
Okay. And then once he comes back, where do you wind up living?
I'm trying to think. Was it Austin?
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm not sure I'm that person.
Yeah. That's right.
For a while.
Yeah.
Okay. And then he stayed in the Air Force?
No, he got out for... I don't know if it was a year or two, and then he went back in.
Okay. And then did that put you then into the life of the military wife? And
Before he went back in, I just worked as a nurse at the health center at University of Texas.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And then he does go back in,
yeah.
and you just follow him around to his
right.
different assignments?
Right.
And so forth. All right.
Mm-hmm.
When you think over the time that you spent, in the service, are there particular incidents or people or memories that kind of stand out for you?
You mean during all the times we were...
Well, actually, the time you were actually on active duty first.
Okay. Yeah. No, it was pretty standard right then, you know, just doing our jobs and having fun with friends on the weekends or whenever we're off.
Okay. Now, you're at the base, you're at that hospital, according to 65 to 68,
mm-hmm.
and that is a point where, of course, Vietnam ramps up a lot.
Right.
Did that affect the kind of business that you had at the hospital? I mean, were there casualties who would come back to that facility?
Well, like I said, I was in OB and
right.
GYN all the time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But I mean, you were aware of what was going on at all, or that these
oh,
people
yes.
were coming in?
Yeah.
Okay. And did you pay any attention to things like the anti-war movement that was going on, or...
I really didn't pay too much attention to that.
Okay. And did you follow the news of the war while your husband was over
right.
there?
And I thought, we shouldn't be there.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And were there ever situations where you got news reports and you were wondering, was he in the middle of that?
Not too much, really.
Okay. All right.
Because a lot of the women that were there having babies and things, you'd hear a lot about any of their husbands that were gone.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't recall that any of them had a husband that had died.
Okay.
Because you have people coming in and out. And
right. Okay. All right. And I guess to look back on the time in the service, I mean, aside from getting you a husband, how do you think that affected you?
Or what did you
or what did you learn from it?
From being in the military,
yeah.
you mean?
Yeah.
Well, like I said, I had planned to be a career woman because I had seen so much camaraderie when we were at the air base in Tripoli, North Africa.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I thought I would like to do that and have that camaraderie with other women that are staying in.
Okay. All right. And
that's what originally had gotten me to the point of going in, really.
Okay. And did it work out that way?
Yes, but I ended up not being a career woman,
mm-hmm.
not in the military.
All right. Now, did you continue to work as a nurse, or did you, after all that, so would you work as a nurse in different places where he was assigned?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. And so then, and when did you retire from nursing?
Oh, in 2000 when I lost my leg.
Oh. Okay.
We're still looking for it.
Okay. All right. But that was not a service-related
thing. No.
Okay.
I should have told people it was.
Yeah, make a much better story.
Or a shark story.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, thank you very much then for taking the time to share the story.
You're welcome.
All right.